بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والعاقبة للمتقين، ولا عدوان إلا على الظالمين. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، أشهد أن نبينا محمدا عبده ورسوله، صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. أما بعد، أهلا وسهلا ومرحبا. Welcome, brothers in Islam, to lesson 219 of Al-Arabiyya Bayn Yadayk, Book 1, Part 1 of the New Version. وقفنا أيها الإخوة عند الصفحة 156. We start at page 156. وسأبدأ اليوم إن شاء الله بالتصحيح الواجب المنزلي. I will start today, inshallah, with marking the homework. وهو بقية هذه الوحدة. And that is the remaining of this chapter, inshallah. إذن, so, التدريب الخامس, the fifth exercise. اقرأ الفقرة ثم أجب عن الأسئلة. واحد. إذن, الجواب الأول, the first answer, هو من تركيا. And هو is not compulsory to write down. So that's why. ولهذا هذا الضمير بين قوسين. This pronoun is between two brackets. إذن الجواب الثاني هو تركي. Or سلمان تركي. الجواب الثالث إلى مكة والمدينة. الجواب الرابع لا. الجواب الخامس للصلاة في المسجد الحرام. الجواب السادس الجمعة أو سيصلي الجمعة أو صلاة الجمعة الجواب السابع سيذهب or without mentioning the verb يوم الخميس إن شاء الله. والجواب الأخير في المسجد النبوي بالشدة على الياء وبالكسرة فوق الحرف وتحت الشدة. فائدة, a benefit. تتضمن هذه الفقرة بعض أحكام النحو. This paragraph contains some of the rules of grammar. منها from them في السطر الأول in the first line للصلاة في المسجد الحرام. للصلاة, إذن لي حرف جر is preposition, والصلاة اسم مجرور is the noun affected by the preposition. أيضا نجد كلمة الصلوات في السطر الثاني. In the second line, we find the word الصلواتي. هنا أيضا حكم نحوي. Here is also a grammatical rule. And that is that الصلواتي is مفعول به. It's an object. Because it's the reply of the what question. The verb plus the what question. So he will pray what? الصلواتي. So why? لماذا لا نجعل الفتحة فوق التاء? Why don't we put a fatha on the ta? Because the maf'ulun bihi object has an fatha. أريد كتابا. أريد قلما، اشتريت كتابا، صليت العصر، لماذا لا نجعل التاء المفتوحة بالفتحة؟ الجواب أن جمع المؤنث السالم لا يقبل الفتحة. The answer is that the female sound plural doesn't accept a fatha. So any plural with the alif open ta can never have a fatha but get a kasra instead. As for al-khamsa, al-khamsa na'tun, it's an adjective. We can call it sifatun. And the na'tun follows the man'utun. And the sifatun follows the mawsufun. What is the word before the adjective? What is as-salawati? But al-khamsa has a fatha because As-salawati should have a fatha. And khamsa is not a jam'u mu'annathin salimun. So it just has a fatha because it should be fatha and default is fatha for the object. So al-khamsa has a fatha because as-salawati should have a fatha. سلمان سيصلي في المسجد الحرام الصلواتي الصلوات مفعول به منصوب وعلامة نصبه الكسرة بدلا من الفتحة لأنه جمع مؤنث سالم الخمسة نعت منصوب الفجر is called بدل and this is something you will study later on inshallah this is called بدل and as you can see all the remaining والظهر والعصر والمغرب they are called معطوف they follow the word before the واو what is الخمسة سلمان سيذهب إلى المدينة يوم الخميس يوم مفتوح هذا فتحة منصوب هذا فتحة لأنه ظرف زمان because it's a time related adverb yeah, it's the reply of the when question متى سيذهب يوم الخميس ويوم مضاف والخميس مضاف إليه النبوي وتكسرة It's a na'tun adjective and it follows the previous word what is al-masjidi with kasra. على كل حال anyway سننتقل we will move إلى التدريب السادس we go to the sixth exercise اقرأ الفقرة read the paragraph ثم ضع علامة صح أو خطأ then put a place the correct sign or the incorrect sign. As you know, أو means or. وهو حرف عطف. It's a connecting letter. What means that the حركة after أو should have the حركة of before the أو. So the word after أو should have the same حركة of the word before أو. So علامة is مفعول به مضاف. صح is مضاف إليه which with the كسرة أو خطأ and خطأ follows صح طيب سأقرأ هذه الفقرة إن شاء الله I will read this paragraph إن شاء الله هناك اختلاف بين طبعتين there is a difference between two prints طبعتي 2004 عشرة و 2015 between 2014 and 2015 print when it comes to the word في مسجد بلال so in one of those prints the name of the masjid is mentioned and in the other one not طيب كما ترون في هذا التعليق as you can see in this footnote في طبعة 2014 تجد you find في المسجد in the masjid ويصلي الفجر في المسجد بدون ذكر اسم المسجد without mentioning the name of the masjid بدلا من instead of في مسجد بلال in the masjid of بلال and that is something you find in the new prints طيب سأبدأ الآن وإذا أردتم أن تجعلوا هذا التدريب إملاءً if you want to make this exercise الإملاء, a dictation. You can close the books inshallah, and then you can read down write down this this paragraph as a dictation. إذن بسم الله. طارق يصلي الظهر والعصر في مسجد عثمان. ويصلي المغرب والعشاء في مسجد علي. طارق يضع المنبه بجانبه ويستيقظ مبكرا ويصلي الفجر في مسجد بلال وينام بعد صلاة الفجر. افتحوا الكتب, open the books, صححوا الإملاء, mark the dictation, وترجموها and translate it, يعني the فقرة, the paragraph. الترجمة, the translation. طارق prays الظهر and العصر in مسجد عثمان. As you can see, في is a حرف جر preposition. مسجد is اسم مجرور, but as you can see, it has only one كسرة and not two. And normally you have two كسرة if there is no L, but it has only one كسرة because it's مضاف. And عثمان is مضاف إليه. But isn't it that the مضاف إليه has a كسرة? Yes. But if we have a word that is ممنوع من الصرف, like the names that end on ألف نون, عثمان and سلمان and عمران and عفان, in that situation, the word is ممنوع من الصرف, and ممنوع من الصرف can never have a كسرة. So what happens? It gets a فتحة instead of a كسرة. And he prays what? المغرب. المغرب is مفعول به. And العشاء follows المغرب because there is a واو between them. معطوف. And he prays المغرب and العشاء in مسجد علي. علي is مضاف إليه. طارق is putting the alarm clock next to him. And he wakes up early. And he prays الفجر in مسجد بلال. And he sleeps after the Fajr prayer. إذن واحد طارق يصلي الظهر في مسجد عثمان. هذا صحيح. اثنان طارق يصلي العشاء في البيت. هذا خطأ. ثلاثة طارق يصلي الفجر في مسجد عثمان. خطأ. أربعة طارق ينام بعد صلاة الفجر. هذا صحيح. خمسة طارق يضع المنبه بجانبه. صحيح. وستة طارق يستيقظ مبكرا. صحيح. بعد ذلك نذهب إلى الصفحة التالية. We go to the next page إن شاء الله. الكتابة, the writing. الكتابة, the writing. اليوم سندرس حرفين. Today we will study two letters. وهما, and they are, الهاء والتاء, المربوطة, the ها and the tight تاء. وليست التاء المفتوحة, and not the open تاء that looks like a boat. الهاء أصعب حرف. الها, the ها, is the most difficult letter. أصعب حرف في الكتابة, in writing. ويحتاج إلى تمرين, and it needs practicing. Okay. فتبدأ, يعني some people they have no problem with the ها. But that does not mean that many, many other people have a problem with the ha. Okay? Many people are struggling with writing down the ha. So the ha is the most difficult letter in the Arabic language. Just look to the first table. انظر إلى الجدول الأولي. Look to the first table. كما ترون, as you lot can see, كتابة الهاء تختلف باختلاف موقعها. يعني the writing of the ha differs with the difference of its location. So it's different in the middle of the word. It's different in the beginning of the word. And at the end of the word, it's also different, as you can see. So writing the ha down is difficult, especially خصوصاً في بداية الكلمة, especially in the beginning of the word. Okay? So how do we write down the ha? فتبدأ, so you start بكتابة الدال. The first thing you do when you want to write the letter ha is to write down a dal. Okay? You know how to write a dal. A dal is not very hard. Okay? So the first thing you do is to write down the dal. So after writing down the letter dal, and as you know, the dal is always on the line. It never goes below the line. And it's not very sharp. So its edge. So when you the edge, when I say edge, I mean the connection between the two sticks. It should not be that sharp. So when you make this line, the first line, you go down of the dal, don't make it that sharp. Okay, but don't make it a bow, because then you go to a ra, although the ra is written below the line. Anyway, so after writing the dal and you're about to lift up the pen, you will keep the pen in its place and then you draw a circle within the dal. This is the ha. And this is something you can find very clearly on YouTube, many videos that shows how to write the Arabic letters. So it's a circle within the dal. Okay, it's a circle within the dal, as you can see, كما ترون. إذن فتبدأ, so you start بكتابة الدال, with writing the dal. ثم تضيف, then you add كرة, a ball. كرة is a ball. I think it's better to say دائرة, a circle. ثم تضيف دائرة, a circle بداخلها, in its inside of it. والهاء, and the ha, my brothers in Islam, وبقية الحروف, and the remaining letters, I mean all letters in the Arabic language. والهاء وبقية الحروف, and the remaining letters, وبقية الحروف الهجائية, and the remaining alphabetic letters, لها أربع حالات, have four situations. You have to know this. When you teach somebody the letters of the Arabic language, you have to tell them there are four situations. There are four situations of any letter. Okay? With a very few exceptions of some letters that never come in the beginning of the word. But in general, maybe 95%, the Arabic letters, they have four situations. الحالة الأولى, the first situation, في بداية الكلمة, in the beginning of the word. كما ترون, as you can see, the ha. This is the ha in the beginning of the word. The ta al-marbuta is empty. I mean the second schedule, the second table. Al-jadwal al-thani. نجد فراغا عند بداية الكلمة. We find blank, we find an open space in the beginning of the word, because the ta al-marbuta never comes in the beginning of the word. So that's what I mean with exception. But normally, عادة, هناك أربع حالات, there are four situations. في بداية الكلمة, in the beginning of the word. So you write each letter different in the beginning of the word. It's not like in the middle of the word, not at the end of the word. So what are these four situations? Always, when you teach a letter, teach them the four situations. الحالة الأولى, the first situation, في بداية الكلمة, in the beginning of the word. And that's like, and today we focus on the ha. So you see how the ha is in the beginning of the word? الحالة الثانية, to the second situation, في وسط الكلمة, in the middle of the word. And the ha, subhanAllah, you can almost say it looks like a number 8, an English 8. Okay? This is called في وسط الكلمة, in the middle of the word. وسطٌ is middle. طيب, الحالة الثالثة, the third situation, في نهاية الكلمة, at the end of the word, or in the end of the word. And when you look to it, the ha, it really looks like a ta marbuta, except that it has no dots. So what is this fourth situation? I mean, we know that there is a situation beginning, middle, end. But what is the number four situation? الحالة الرابعة والأخيرة, the fourth and last situation, is when it's not joined. Remember this. Okay? So you have an attached letter and a detached letter. Okay, so that's why I have written this, but still joined. Okay, في نهاية الكلمة, at the end of the word, this is the third situation. وهي متصلة, but it's attached. It's still joined. And this takes us, my brothers in Islam, to the fourth and last situation, that is when it's مجردة, when it's solely, when it's on its own, and that is the fourth and the last situation, and that is on the top left of the first table. Okay, so as you can see, my brothers in Islam, the ha at the end of the word is not written in one way, just like the jim, ha, kha, and all the other letters. Okay, so you have, somebody says, how do you write the sin? Or the sheen, or the jim, ha, kha. Okay? How do you write the dal at the end of this sentence, end of the word? Then the question is, do you mean if it's attached, or do you mean if it's mujarradatun, on its own, detached? So please bear that in mind. Okay? طيب. إذن, we have a few words, my brothers in Islam, related to the ha, and in each word has a one of these four situations. So the ha in the beginning of the word is like هذا. هذا ما معنى هذا؟ This مثلا بحذف الألف بين, with the deletion of the ألف between الحرفين الأولين, with the deletion of the ألف between the first two letters. هذا نعم, هذا كتابة لا نطقا. So we delete the ألف between the ha and the ذال, in writing, not in pronunciation. So you say hada, you don't say hada, you say hada. Then we delete the alif between the ha and the dal. Hada is this masculine. بعد ذلك الظهر. الظهر is what you call the noon prayer. الظهر. And prayers normally have always L. Okay? صليت, I prayed, صليت الظهر. هذا أذان الظهر. Normally you have always an L with all the five prayers. And also al-Jumu'ah. And we also have al-dhahru with shadda and a fatha, and that is the back. And we have done that when we talked about the body parts. So the back is al-dhahru, or without al-dhahru. بعد ذلك منبه, an alarm, or alarm clock. هذه this feminine. ننتقل, we move إلى الجدول الثاني, to the second table. في اللغة العربية ثلاثة حروف لا ترد في بداية الكلمة. Now, in the Arabic language, there are three letters that are not mentioned or that doesn't come in the beginning of the word. So as you can see, when we talked about the ta' al-marbota, is just empty. It's empty in two places, in the beginning of the word and in the middle of the word. So the ta' al-marbota, the ta' never comes in the beginning of the word, and also never comes in the middle of the word. So there are three words, sorry, there are three letters in the Arabic language that are not mentioned in the beginning of the word. What are these three letters, my brothers in Islam? At-ta' al-marbuta is one of them. Aydan al-alifu. Al-alif is never mentioned in the beginning of the word because the alif can only come after fatha. It's a stretching letter. For example, the word door, babun. Or the word book, kitabun. It stretched the fatha of the ta, kitabun. So, what is this stick that you find on the top of this page? Al-kitabatu. This stick is not an alif, but it's a hamzatul wasli, a weak hamza, my brothers in Islam. Okay? Likewise, iqra, top of the previous page. Iqra, this is called hamzatul wasli. It's not called an alif. Bear that in mind. Also, undur is hamzatul wasli and not an alif. Idan alif, and this is called hamzatun ala satri, hamza on the line, also doesn't come in the beginning of the word, and Allah knows best. Wa at-ta'ul marbutatu, and the tight ta. When I say التاء المربوطة, as you can see, التاء المربوطة has two shapes. لها شكلان. التاء المربوطة لها شكلان, has two shapes. متصلة ومنفصلة. When it's attached, like مكة, and when it's detached, صلاة. And that's why I say, my brothers in Islam, letters, they have four situations. When you say end of the word, explain them. Attached, like Mekkatu, okay? And detached, it looks totally different. Detached like a ball with two sifl, with two dots. A ball with two dots. طيب, كما أن التاء المربوطة, likewise, the تاء المربوطة لا ترد في وسط الكلمة. It's not mentioned in the middle of the word. بخلاف الحرفين الآخرين. Unlike the two other letters. Which two other letters? I'm talking about these two other letters. So the ta' al-marbuta doesn't come in the middle of the word. Unlike the two other letters, the alif comes in the middle, and the hamzatun ala as-satri, the hamza on the line, as well comes in the middle. And there is one word where both are mentioned in the middle. As in the word al-qira'atu. So we have an alif in the middle, and the alif stretches the fatha of the ra. Al-qira'atu. Okay? What means the reading. للتاء المربوطة والهاء صورتان. The تاء المربوطة and the هاء, they have two forms, two shapes. Okay, I'm talking about the ta al marbut and the ha when they are at the end of the word, في نهاية الكلمة. صورة متصلة. صورة doesn't mean picture here but shape or form. An attached form. صورة منفصلة. And a detached form. As you can see, my brothers, in Islam, in the word منبه is متصل. هذه منفصل. مكة متصل. وصلاة منفصل. I hope that you have also made the remaining of the homework, inshallah. I will continue this, inshallah, in the next class. Subhanakallahumma wa bihamdika. Ashhadu an la ilaha illa anta astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.